begin to prosper in their souls. They'll begin to prosper in their health. They'll begin to prosper in their lives, saith the Lord.
That even within this season, there should be getting to awaken the intercessors. And I declare that even the watchmen shall begin to arise in a greater measure of strength and boldness. And I declare that they will begin to run with the zeal of God in the name of Jesus. And I declare that they will no longer be faint at heart, but that they will stand firm in the God that they serve. So I declare a season of encounters in the name of Jesus. And I declare that their eyes will see. And I declare that their ears will hear. And I declare that they will take rest in who you are. And I declare that they will begin to release strategy and tactics. And I declare that their eyes will peer and soar into the distance. And I declare that they will sound the alarm. And I declare that their mouth shall be open wide. And I declare that as their mouths are open, that you shall fill it with your word. I declare that you release new measures of truth to your intercessors. I declare that even now, that they will drink from the well that will never run dry. So I prophesy an awakening to every intercessor. I prophesy an awakening to the watchmen. I decree and declare that even prophetic intercession in this house shall arise to a new grace in the name of Jesus. And thank you that you release your strength and your peace that surpasses all understanding. Thank you that you want to break through new measures of torment and fear and resistance. Thank you that their heart will take courage in that which you've shown them. Thank you that their ears are sensitive to that which you're speaking to them. Thank you that they will stand and that they will declare the word of the Lord. And thank you, Father, that you begin to release grace. Thank you that you release zeal. Thank you that you release passion. Cause their heart to burn once again. Cause their heart to be minute with the health and the vision. Cause them to be able to break through confusion, jealousy, strife. Cause them to pray new realms of unity within the house. So cause them to be emerging with the intercessors, with the worship leaders, and with the prophetic leaders of this house in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We're going to do something. There is, as the Lord spoke to me concerning hardness of heart in this house. This discouragement has been so strong that it's caused a hardness, a coldness to God. And I believe God's going to send the fire again. He's going to send the fire again. He's going to send the fire again. All is not lost. How many of you believe that? Come in with this hat, this red hat on. And I hope it's a bull's hat. Because you got to get out of here. What kind of hat is that? Is it bull? All right, okay. Sit in here with that. Come here. The Lord says this will be a sign to you that if you repent and submit, I will open up doors to employment you don't deserve. You will be. The Lord is going to open up something that you do not qualify for. Your frustration with your inability to provide how you want has been because God has you in a holding stewardship, because he's not done with you. You were done with him, but he ain't done with you. The call of God upon your life has not gone anywhere, and you will not taste death until every prophecy that has gone on over your life is manifested with power and with great wisdom. And the best way to describe it is some form of conspiracy where something is fighting you from an external party. And the Lord says he is about to bring swift justice to you. You have cried over it being unfair, but if you will humble yourself, God will give you victory and you will have provision. And come here, there's a mass exodus coming to your life. Satan sent a season to you through people that had you doing things you never thought you would ever do. But the Lord is about to cause a swift exit to place you back. Man, you had a near-death experience. Death scheduled. You were supposed to die. I literally see you with the wrong people, and death had certified papers on you by bullet, sir. You escape by grace. Now you know what I'm talking about. I see that death claimed you, and you saw your life flash before your eyes. The Lord said it was redemption and mercy to place you. There are hundreds of young people that you carry in your heart. Wow. Now you feel like you were dropped. And at the moment where you needed God's people forgot about you. But the Lord wants you to know if you will give it a try again, He's going to heal those wounds in your life and get great glory out of you, even in this. Come on, put those hands together for the Lord. Come on. Come on, put those hands what's your name? Fabian, come here. Is your wife here? Glory to God. Wife, come. Come on, come quickly. Glory to God. Glory to God. The Lord says you complain about the thing you're here to do. You nag about the problems to the solutions that you carry within you. And it had seemed as if you were on your way to a promotion and it was intercepted by one jealous. And intercepted by somebody who envied you. But the Lord said the season is coming around. There have been many nights where you have convinced your wife to remain faithful to what God was calling y'all to do in this house. And the Lord said, because you heeded and you did not run, everything you lost last November, the Spirit of the Lord says He's going to restore sevenfold. You are something dramatic happened. That should have ended your marriage. That should have ended your money. That should have ended all of it. Satan tried to kill you. I don't know exactly what happened. But Satan literally tried to cause you to lose your mind. Okay. But God has brought you over into a season of sobriety. And your heart of sonship in this house is going to be rewarded by the Lord. Stay faithful. You are one of the help that's getting ready to be recognized in this world. You need to be what you needed when you first got here. And you need to leave that anger alone because you feel like you didn't have it how you wanted it. God is going to make you the answer to a lot of your complaint. But He had to get some stuff out of you. Glory to God. Some trauma out of you. Praise the Lord. If you will give this whole thing, God is healing this marriage. I feel like there's a blow that has hit this house, a devastating one. And the Lord says, if you will give it a try, He will redeem it and make it a testimony to this house. Now, I see shame on you. I don't know what this is, but I see embarrassment on you. But you feel like people are laughing at you for something, sir. I want you to know, whoa, only a father can fix this. Only a father can fix this. Father, release that redemption over this precious couple. In the name of Jesus, make them a part of the future that you've given this house. In the name of Jesus. Sister Porter, will you come, please? The Holy Ghost says when you talk about retiring, it offends Him. It grieves His heart. And this word is a rebuke that you are to never talk about coming off of a post He called you to. Ever again. You have been so overwhelmed with what you had seen and what you had heard that you had said, just put me in a classroom. Maybe I'm pushing something that will never be supported. But the Holy Ghost says, woman, you are graced for what He called you to do in this building. And I begin to hear pastors from other states upon cell phones saying, come here, help us. You can go there. But the Lord says, I am setting watchmen upon the wall. Glory to God. There's a renewed passion coming to you. And God's about to stop this bleeding. You are concerned so grievously about the future of this house. And the Lord says he's going to take that concern and make it creativity for what you need to do. Don't drop the mantle. Pick that thing back up. Like, ooh, give me this. Come on. Let's pray. Scream in this house. Apostle Greg, here's the word of the Lord. You are going into a season that cannot be delegated. And this season is going to be a season where he sends you sons that's going to be very uncomfortable because there is a closeness that they've never had to you and you to them. And there's going to be a moment of discipleship that's going to bring an unprecedented fulfillment to your heart. You are about to go into a time of crafting destinies and of sculpting skill sets. And the Lord said it's going to create a revival and break out of the entire house. I see a group of men, young, old, different walks of life, that are sitting at your feet literally on a weekly basis for the point of leadership. And you're going to learn again that much of the vision of this house that you believe that had died is going to be resurrected through the strength of the young. The Father says your wisdom, your patience, and your courage is replicatable. And he is getting ready to pour you out upon those that are unsuspecting, upon those that don't look like much, upon those that don't even realize they are called to ministry. But the Lord says this is a time of impartation. Begin to lay your hands upon them. And you're going to see that there are those that carry the articulation for the future of the house that you see. This is the season for the future revealed. And God's going to begin to unearth memories, visions, instructions that have gathered dust over the years. And they're going to become more apparent to you, more clear to you, and more precise to you than ever before. I'm getting ready, God says, to give you an eye for greatness in a way that you could have never seen. And there'll be many that try to nag at you about it. There'll be many who say you need to put your energies elsewhere. But the Lord says he has given you a fresh apostolic grace to form the future of this house by men and women who don't look like much. It's going to be that grace to recognize them. And there's going to be skill. There's going to be impartation. But most importantly, they're going to tie hearts to yours. And you're never again going to worry about the security of the future of this house. Because the Lord says, this is the year where I'm revealing it. And this is the year where I'm securing it. And this is the year where the trajectory of this house is going to be made sure. And you're going to hit cruise control for another assignment that God's going to reveal very, very soon. Come on, put those hands together for the Lord. Come on, put those hands together for the Lord. We're going to take, how many of you believe this word was from the Lord? How many of you believe this? How many of you are going to pray this? Come on. You are called to be emotionally traumatized. The crazy is your portion. Do not send them away. Don't do it. You are a counselor by nature. And the Holy Ghost has posted you here. For there was one that vacated that assignment, and the Lord says, have not I put this upon your shoulders? This is why your warfare has been what it's been. because I've anointed you for this assignment in this house and in this season. In Jesus' name, I'm going to get a move on you just a little bit. There is a scribe's anointing coming upon you, woman of God. I see a book traveling this nation. The Lord says, prepare yourself. I see a documentary, and there is a media revival coming through you, and I'm getting ready to cause men by the hundreds to submit to you. Now, you are in the midst of a very tough decision right now, of a very hard decision of left and right. The Lord says, the dream of the Lord is about to come to you to let you know that you're not trying to hurt people. You are following God. There is a hunger that's growing in you for a level of ministry you would have never have forecasted yourself to be in. And there have been mentors that have taken credit for all that God is doing in your life right now. But the Lord says, I'm getting ready to unveil your teachers, and I'm getting ready to give you diverse connections. But revival is coming through the pen of a ready writer. You just told somebody, if I could sit still long enough to get my thoughts together, I would get a book done. But the Lord says, I'm about to craft a team around you. And many are they that look at you and say, well, who do you think you are? We were there when you were filled with the Holy Ghost, and we came to get you when you didn't have nowhere to go. But the Lord says, I'm getting ready. This is what the Lord wants you to know. He has given you grace for closure. Wow. You are about to see closure, because there is a new grace and a new people and a new thing and a new strengthening and a new impartation coming to you. And yes, the Lord says, even school, he is about to open up the door for an academic program, because there is a policy needed. Get ready. I'm opening BET up to you. I'm getting ready to bring you in hip-hop culture in a way that you can have never seen. And there shall be religious snakes that try to coil themselves around you. There shall be promoters, and there shall be those that attach themselves to you. But I'm getting ready to give you heightened discernment in this hour to know who to attach yourself to and who to remove yourself from. And the Lord says, do not weary yourself with the accusation of that jealous woman. For I'm getting ready, said God, to vindicate your reputation and to reward you. And I'm getting ready to move you eons ahead of where you thought you could go. And I don't know what's going on with your house, but I heard God say, I'm blowing on your living situation. Prepare yourself, for there have been a complication that had prevented you from getting the living space that you wanted. But the Lord says, I'm getting ready to clean up the small print, because I opened your house up, said God. But they will not allow you to do in other ministries. I'm going to open you up. You've got to have enough bedrooms for men and women to come and be delivered in their sleep and be delivered in their dreams. And you're going to own and own and own and own again. Maybe I see demons raining over you. Prepare yourself. You will not see anything yet. Come on, give them a praise. We're going to sow into this. I believe that God sends seasons in people. He sends seasons in people. And let me warn you with this. Woe unto you. Woe unto you that gangbang and thug and mafia the help that God is sending. You are going to answer to the God of these people's callings. God is about to bring an accountability for hurting help that he sent. Come on, church. Prophets, am I hearing? I mean, shout out, show, shake. Is this the word of the Lord? Okay, thank you. All right, amen. I feel good about that. God is about to bring an accountability, glory to God, for biting the help that he is sending. Praise the Lord God. We're going to take an offering, and we're going to take it on. Sister Regina, come here. I want the ushers to come, but they have envelopes. We're going to sow real hard. Come here. Lord have mercy. I see a wet pillow. And I see an I quit. Because every time you open up your mouth, Satan hits your house. And Satan hits your confidence. And Satan hits you. And you have felt like, well, maybe it's me. Maybe I'm just too passive. Maybe I should just keep silent and pray.
But the Lord says, have not I made you a sign? Don't be silent. He has made you a sign. The word of the Lord to you is that you were sent for this season. All of the years prior to was practice. But I'm going to tell you what's happened to you. God is taking you through some conflicts at this house to make you confident in your own sound. Your problem is you measure yourself to the loud mouths. And the Lord wants you to know that you may not be Elijah, you may not be an Ezekiel, but I made you a name. I have made you a Nathan. I have made you the counsel to the king. You spirit that kills the prophets. We bind you in Jesus. Oh, let's get an offering in your hand. How many of you believe that God is about to send you some help? Who receives that? I said, who receives that? How many of you believe that God is sending you some help? Glory to God. Get an offering, every one of you. All nation, all of you. Take that cheeseburger money and get you some. We are all sowing on this. We are all sowing on this. The help is getting ready to come. The help is getting ready to come. We got a microphone. Come on, we're going to sow to this. Yes, sir. Apostle Greg said he is hearing that these prophets, and I agree, need to sow the biggest offering they can into this. Because I believe what God is doing is he is binding gag orders off of the prophets of this hour. Sow into prophetic recognition. You guys are going to be the recruiters in this season. Get you an offering and sow into this, every one of you. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come on, get something in your hand. Wow. Get something in your hands. We're going to sow. We're going to sow into this. And when you're ready, step up. We're going to make some decrees.
For these businesses, for these purposes, for these ideas, for these plans, for these programs, let the help be released. And we sow in faith that you have sent and you have revealed and you have unveiled the next season of help. In the name of Jesus, we sow in faith and we say you will respond to the help that you're sending in this hour. But we will protect what you're sending in the name of Jesus. Go on and bring those offerings to the baskets. They're going to pass the baskets. Glory to God. Come on. Jesus.
We're going to dismiss because we know some of you need to go. You might have young kids. If you need to get home, get to bed, whatever. But Apostle Matthew's going to continue to minister to people. So if you want to stay around, you're very welcome to, for a ministry to be received. If you need to go, you can be dismissed, all right? So don't feel bad about it. If you have to go, it's fine. Just love on somebody. Speak an encouraging word to somebody. If you have children downstairs, be sure you get your kids before you go. All right? Thank you so much.